unlocking the genetic secrets of Earth's most ancient living lineage of flowering plants, the original source of genes for all economically important flowering crops, is the goal of a new $7.3 million five-year-long research project led by Claude dePamhilis, professor of biology at Penn State University. The project involves the complex task of discovering the genetic structure of a plant, a rare species called Amborella.
Amborella is special because it represents the earliest branch off of the tree of life of flowering plants. We can use it to form a triangle in comparison with important crop plants like the grasses.
Sequencing the Amborella genome and making it freely available to the scientific community on the project's website will allow scientists to explore a large number of questions about how flowering plants originated, when important genes in flowering plants emerged, and whether genome duplication was a force that resulted in the incredible diversity of living varieties of flowering plants. The scientists plan to use next-generation sequencing methods and a cost-effective strategy that has been tested on rice genomes and is superior to traditional sequencing methodologies.
Our being able to sequence Amborella has been made possible by a new kind of sequencing we call next-generation sequencing that basically is producing sequence data 1,000 times faster and many times cheaper than the more traditional methods.
The new research project builds on the results from two other efforts led by dePamphilis at Penn State: the Floral Genome Project, which began in 2001, and the Ancestral Angiosperm Genome Project, which began in 2007. Watch an extended interview with Claude dePamphilis to learn more about Amborella. For ScienceCast, I'm Katrina Voss.